be faster. They are going to describe Korea plus the future, so 50 minutes will be enough for sure. But I will try to compress a little bit the old story, the recent old story, and give you an outlook. The motivation why I'm starting from 2010 is to give you an idea of the progress, the kind of difficulties we have faced over the time and the way in which we are trying to figure out how to cope with them. So first, a couple of words on the CLAI initiatives in general, then we'll pinpoint some important items from year to year and the plans for the future. So the CLAI initiative. We have in this reorganization process, we started since Carol retired, trying to figure out a way of defining what is a CLAI. And now we have produced a charter which says what is CLAI, what are the aims, how it works, and so on. So CLAI is a self-organized body which aims at promoting research and development for information access systems. And we have the traditional focus on multilinguality, which is our core business, and multimodality, because you know some of the large interest deals with multimedia information. But what we have tried to highlight as much as possible is that we work with information with different degrees of structure. So we can range from unstructured typical textual document to semi-structured XML document, or if in the future someone with a semantic interest wants to join, also with structured documents. In this renewal process, as Doug was anticipating, who knows who has copied from who, we have decided to have to go for an independent event, which is now constituted by the evaluation labs, what has been always the tracks, plus a conference, which is a kind of think tank for evaluation in the field, next evaluation activities, or make development or reassessment on what we have done in the past. One important thing that now both the labs and the conference are peer reviewed. So this is somehow different from the past. We have strict criteria for selecting the labs and the criteria for publishing papers in the proceedings. This is no more something that you get automatically participating in CLAI activities. And we have tried to involve as much as possible also external and external sponsorship, which in our case typically means some industrial sponsorship which changes from year to year, and support from different European projects. And as also Zander was saying, when you change something, suddenly feels the need of changing the name. So we moved from cross-language evaluation forum to conference labs of the evaluation forum. This is because we have enlarged a little bit the scope, no more only multilingual staff and different kinds of data structures. We have also reduced a bit the steering committee, and we have procedures now for rotating the steering committee and so on and so forth. So, how we arrived here? We started this work in 2010 when we had this idea of having the conference and the labs, and to see this as a building where the different parts mutually reinforce each other towards scientific and technological progress. decided in 2010 was to have 2 days of conference and 2 days of labs. So we had a good participation, some external sponsors, many interesting talks, talks about the other evaluation initiatives, panels, and quite a few papers submitted to the conference. And we had 5 benchmarking activities and 2 workshops. So what are benchmarking activities, the labs and the workshops? So benchmarking activities are tracks, basically. Workshops are something in between a workshop to a conference. They obviously, the topic must be evaluation in some domain, and a pilot task, a pilot lab. It's a kind of sandbox for discussing, meeting people, and see if in the next year something can become a real evaluation lab. In any case, there is nothing automatic. I mean, if a workshop is set 1 year, this not automatically means that it will become or it will be accepted as a lab next year. And so, in 2010, Pan joined us for the first time, I guess, Paolo. Yes, and we have also another lab on web people search and searching workshop on search for expert targets, social media. In 2011, we went to Amsterdam, we finalized the charter, and we reorganized a little bit the program and decided to not have 2 days of conference and 2 days of lab, but to interleave the sessions so that it's a continuous flow for participants to move from a conference session to an overview talk, a keynote talk to a lab session. Please to favor the discussion and the reciprocal knowledge of the people. We had a very good attendees, and we had a slightly more papers, keynote talks, community sessions on other evaluation initiative organized by Product Plus, and so on and so forth. That year, we didn't have new labs, but we had two new workshop pilot benchmarking activities. Then we had a play, that we just had a play in September in Rome. The attendance increased again, so now it's really, really big, and probably we are near to a maximum because 200 people is really a huge event to be managed. This year we kept the same format as last year. We had still a progressive increase in the number of papers. These are the number of published papers, but we had much more submission, so we had the possibility of being more selective. We had the keynote talks and the community session, the one on the other evaluation initiative, and another one that could be a nice idea also for FIRE. Basically, evaluation clinic is giving people the possibility of talking with evaluation experts of their problems. They may be PhD students, but maybe also companies or industries. They meet there and they have a couple of hours for discussing these topics. And we moved a little bit in the number of evaluation labs, because we passed from 5 to 7. SHIC actually was a workshop the previous year and became a lab, and we had a very good opportunity that was the one of joining forces with IDEX, that decided to come in the context of will for sure tell you much more about IELTS in the next talk. And we had a workshop on evaluation issues in the health domain, more NLP oriented. So, where the next class will be, you should ask everything to Paolo, who is the main organizer of class this year. So I'm just synthesizing the things here. It will be in Valencia from 23 to 26 September. The registrations to the labs are now open and you can find